Buying an iPhone has always been a dream or a first priority for smartphone buyers around the world, whether for the unique design language, longevity, or for the Apple logo itself. iPhone is the phone to get for many. When some can afford it brand new, but many prefer to buy a used or refurbished iPhones from different online or offline stores. And this is where many first-time buyers get fooled by a cloned or a master copy of the original iPhones. Hey everyone, Trithiv here from TGT and welcome to another video. And in this video, I am going to show you some basic ways to identify a fake iPhone with ease. The first is the most convenient and official way to check for a genuine iPhone, and this is by checking the serial number itself. For that, let's find the serial number first. Go to Settings, then General, then About, and the serial number is here. Then open the browser and go to the website checkcoverage.apple.com. Here, enter your device serial number and type in the security code and hit continue. And just like this, the serial number will be matched with the Apple database and it will show you whether your device has a valid purchase date or not. This website will also tell you about the present warranty situation of the device as well. The second, well, it might sound silly, but it is actually the screws that are used. Apple always use pentalock screws for the chassis of the iPhone. Internally, they use many other types, but for this position, they use pentalock screws only. For a fake iPhone, there is a chance that they will use normal crosshead screws here. So if you can check, have a close look at the screws. The third is the mute-unmute switch. Well, this switch has been an identity of iPhones from day one. While many other buttons such as the power buttons and the SIM tray has changed its position in different iPhone generations. For example, in an iPhone SE first generation, the power button is at the top and the SIM tray is at the right. For the newer models, this is at the right side and the SIM tray is at the left side. But this mute switch is in this position from the beginning and the toggle feels really steady. Also, if you mute the device, you will see a reddish orange strip right at this position. This color has also remained same for most of the models throughout the generations and for any device color. So for a fake device, this might be in a different position or the strip color might be different. Position of the Apple logo at the back. Apple has always been known for the high standards of finishing and perfection in every corner of their devices. The Apple logo at the back is no exception. The finishing and the placement of the logo is always perfect for any original iPhone. It is completely flush to the body for the iPhones, for older metal back devices, and for the newer glass back devices, it has the under the glass finishing. It's shiny and placed into perfection. Till the iPhone XR and XS Max generation, the logo is at the upper side of the device and at the bottom, there is the iPhone branding. From iPhone 11 onwards, the logo is right at the center and there is no iPhone branding. So do check the logo. If you feel it is protruding, not placed in proper position or off center, or it looks recessed, then it might be a fake iPhone. Examine the charging port. Apart from the older iPhone 5C models, which was made of plastic, every other newer generation iPhones have a metallic ring around the lightning port. If you find out that the ring is made of plastic, then that is a fake one. Check the edges. As I told you before about the high standard finishing of Apple devices, the iPhone edges where the screen ends are completely flushed and perfectly sealed. There should not be any abrupt gap between the screen and the metal body. Also, you should feel the uniformity around the edge and throughout the body in an original iPhone. Check the camera module. Usually, the height of the camera module on the back of a fake iPhone is less compared to that of the original. But it might be difficult for you to guess if you are a first-time iPhone user. So with that, do check the picture quality, which should differ. The fake one probably delivers a poor quality and blurry images. IMEI, check with the box. Now, this is a special case scenario. If you are buying an iPhone and the seller is saying that it comes with the original box, then do check the IMEI number of the device with that of the box. The serial number should also be printed in the box. To find the IMEI, go to your device, then settings, then general, then about, then scroll down a bit and you will find the IMEI here. Feel the antenna bands. Apple's antenna band design is always unique for different iPhone generations. Say for example the iPhone 6s and for iPhone 7. The antenna bands should always look like this for the corresponding iPhone models. So while buying an iPhone, comparing the antenna band design with an original image of that phone might provide you another way to identify the fake one. Also, the antenna bands are always flushed with the body of the iPhone, so it should not protrude or appear as printed from outside in an original one. Display quality. The display panel of any original iPhone is always of high standard. Whether it is a LCD or a LED one, the Retina display Apple provides is vibrant, sharp, and perfectly color balanced. Also, for the newer generation models, the display is laminated. So if you look at from this angle, the icons should appear floating over the screen in an original iPhone. Also, the 3D touch should work properly for iPhone 6s and onwards. So do check the display quality, and if it looks dull, then it might not be original. And last but not the least, check the overall unboxing experience. Now, this is for a specific scenario. If you are buying a brand new device but still doubtful about the genuineness of that, then this might help you. The unboxing experience of any Apple device is always unique. The quality of the box, the pull tabs, the packaging is always of high standard. I have unboxing videos of both brand new and refurbished iPhones in this channel. You can check those out in need so that you know what to expect within the box exactly. So I hope these points will help you to spot a fake iPhone when you are buying a second hand or a refurbished one, because that is the scenario when there is a chance that you get fooled by a fake seller. So if this video is helpful, do like, do comment, and do share it with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to TGT. I'll see you in my next one. Peace.